Hi friends, now in today's DAMS Medicine Unplugged series, I have selected a very important clinical case, a common clinical case if you're in a developing country like India, and a common chest x-ray to look at. The entire idea is about the disease being common and you need to know about it. You can't miss out on this disease if you're practicing in India. And I know some of you are already able to make a diagnosis. We're going to talk about something to do with tuberculosis today. Let's look at the history. We have a history of a 26-year-old man with fever and backache. This is the combination. 2 months duration is 2 months duration. Fever, backache. This is what we the patient presented to you with, and this is the chest X-ray film for you. Now, where do you think is the finding in this chest X-ray? This is your cardiac cilhout. These are your lung fields. Where is the finding? The finding is in the mediastinum. You see there is a mediastinal shadow, there is widening of the mediastinum here. You can see this paravertebral shadows converging onto the spine on this frontal chest x-ray here. Now the key is, whenever you look at a x-ray finding like this, you need to look at the clavicles. And do you see that the disease is clearly extending over the clavicles? Yes. You can clearly see the disease is present, the mediastinal lesion is present above the clavicle as well. If it is present above the clavicle as well, it has to be in the posterior mediastinum. This is what is called as cervicothoracic sign. If it was an anterior mediastinal lesion, it would stop at the clavicle. If you see the clear cut superior margin above the clavicle, we believe it is posterior mediastinum. So when we look at posterior mediastinal lesions, we think of things like neurogenic tumors or spine lesions, or we talk about things like paravertebral abscess. These are the kind of things that come to your mind, or a duplication cyst. This is what you are in your mind when you look at a posterior mediastinal lesion. This is a paravertebral lesion here converging onto this, showing cervicothoracic sign. A CT scan of this patient was advised. Let's look at the CT scan here. On the CT scan, you can see this is your thoracic vertebra, and you can see there is destruction, osteolytic destruction of the vertebra. But what else do you see? Along with this, you can see there is pre-paravertebral soft tissue, and that soft tissue has a characteristic rim enhancement. The center is hypodense and there is rim enhancement. Rim enhancement in a soft tissue lesion means abscess. So we are saying there is destruction of the vertebra, there is lytic destruction of the vertebra with pre-paravertebral abscess. Let's look at one more section, which is clearly showing you there is destruction. There are some fragments left, some destruction, some lytic, some fragments left, along with pre-paravertebral abscess. Same rim enhancement that you see around the lesion, but you see the hypodensity, and you see this is typical of an abscess. A coronal reconstruction was done, which shows you that abscess, which is now telling you why the chest x-ray had those paravertebral shadows converging onto the spine. We can see the correlation between the x-ray finding and the CT finding by looking at this coronal reconstruction. We can also do a sagittal reconstruction, which shows you the extent. You can see now the abscess is extending from the C7 to D4, D5 level, and you can see the extent of the disease. And I'm sure most of you are able to now pick up there is destruction, lytic destruction, osteolytic destruction of the vertebra at multiple levels, at the upper thoracic levels with pre-paravertebral abscess, which we picked up on a chest x-ray. We saw the cervicothoracic sign. We saw the rim enhancement, which means abscess. What do you think? That is what I talked to you at the beginning of the thought process itself. This is typical of a disease called as tuberculosis. We're looking at pot spine. Now, when we look at a CT finding, we saw those destruction of the vertebral bodies with the cold abscess that we saw extending from C7 to D4. Typically, your pot spine is a paradiscal disease, involves the disc. On the X-ray, usually you see the loss of disc space in the beginning of the disease. And it depends on the morphology, can be variable. Sometimes you may have difficulty in diagnosing it. All said and done, with the modalities that we have seen, there is something missing in the entire discussion. I'm sure some of you were able to pick it up. That is MRI. Today, in today's era, MRI is considered the investigation of choice for pot spine. It can pick up bone marrow edema at the early stages of the infection. It can pick up that spondylodiscitis that happens because of tuberculosis. It can pick up abscess. It can pick up intraspinal component, which may cause myelopathy. It can help you to follow up. MRI is the key here. So although we saw a case on a CT with a X-ray, but I wanted you to have this message that do not forget the role of MRI. Tuberculosis may have skip involvement where MRI helps you. It can helps you to differentiate a neoplasm from tuberculosis. It can help you to see the epidural component, the compressive myelopathy, the spinal cord compression, heal evidence of healing that would happen in due course on ATT. I also want to make it a point to tell you that when we look at an X-ray, if you see an isolated vertebral body collapse with preserved discs, usually we think in classic radiology, we'll think about things like, it's not always true, but we think of things like trauma or a neoplasm. Posterior convexity of the vertebra, if you see, we think of a neoplasm causing expansion of the vertebra. If we see vertebral collapse with loss of adjoining disc, we think of infective etiologies like tuberculosis, which is a classic disease that we were discussing today in this Unplugged series. So the key take-home messages from today's Unplugged series are cervicothoracic sign, rim enhancement, inner soft tissue lesion means abscess, vertebral destruction, contiguous multiple levels with adjoining abscess is typically tubercular in Indian context. And we talked about how to approach the entire thing, but do not forget the role of MRI. Do not forget the role of MRI. MRI has a big role to play in pot spine. I hope you enjoy the Unplugged series that we do on DAMS Daily channel on YouTube. Do follow us on YouTube for more such education videos, and do scroll back on the YouTube channel to look at previous videos that we have done. I believe that this YouTube channel in itself has a like a big collection of medical education videos free of cost. Do just subscribe, click on subscribe. When you see this channel, you'll get an alert when we post a video next time. I wish you all the best.